I think we should have a severe wage rise for driving in these conditions.
Coming here.
Nous êtes ici en Strasbourg pour le chalet pour Stockport, Angleterre. Et ici il fait très froid aujourd'hui. It's looking like it's going to be another night without sleep. Well, I can't help it. That's what you finish up like when you're working for Peter Cochrane. Just a walking zombie. Hello, Peter. Hi. Where do you want this? Where? Baghdad? 3 o'clock in the morning. I know we're double man, but it's still a bit much. And never mind, I'll be there. I'll ring you when I'm tipped. All right, ta-da. had another griller today, as me and all. So we thought we'd just blow the froth off a couple. Old frissing bills, lad. Great stuff it is. Just the job. Beautiful. What's this railway liner? Tell it's bumpy over here.
No time to stop. Always leave it, always go. Kissing and cuddling now.
Easy. automobile.
Clears rubbing to shreds.
And that's where he tossed him out the door.
On the outskirts of Paris, and
it's good though.
Interview our latest member of the team, Mr. Yasser Arafat.
It's so nice to be here with you. God bless you, my son.
Arafat, obviously you've come through a lot of changes recently. Could you tell us? What's the most significant difference? The most significant difference being an employed driver for PCH as opposed to being self-employed for the PLO.
Two things why I came to PCH. The first was to find out whether BBC interviewer uses a beer bottle instead of a microphone, and the second was for the money. And now I get £4 for PCH.
A week,
yes, not an hour, a week, you see, and so I come to PCH. And they say they are such wonderful people at PCH, and so I come and this is why I am here.
But excuse me, Mr. Lewis, Mr. Arafat.
Yes, that's my name.
Do the political views at PCH not differ from those at the PLO?
To refer that question to my political advisor, Monsieur Baldrick.
Well, I would like to say, as on behalf of Mr. Yasser Arafat, that no.
Here we are, Mr. Arafat. Previous to commencing work for PCH, did you have any previous long distance experience?
Oh, indeed I did, sir. Yes, indeed, sir.
Yes.
Oh, yes, sir. I was a long distance camel driver for many years.
That still holds a mystery for a lot of people. Can you explain how you got the camels to go for so long without water, Mr. Arafat?
It's really quite simple to experienced camel drivers. When we fill up camel with water, camel is drinking water, we brick camel with two bricks on each side of testicles, and we bang
good
camels.
Good grief.
And they go, the result is, and they take on more water for the journey.
Good grief, Mr. Arafat, I begin to grimace myself with that remark. But can you tell me, did that not hurt?
Only when you reach your fingers in between the stones.
Mr. Bingley, you're cracking
up
there.
Yes. Quite, yes, I think...
We've never been this close before, myself and Richard Dimbleby. We have never
Bingley.
Been this close before.
quite right. But I think it's
one of us should drink this, I think.
It's just the same when we fill up a cupboard of fuels.
What?
Dusty dreams of yesterday, I reminisce alone.